T73 demolition rocket launcher mounted on an M4 medium tank developed for the Janet Board. Its purpose is to breach anti-tank obstacles and to neutralize or destroy enemy emplacements that might otherwise have to be blasted by hand-placed charges. The front and sides are armored against 20 millimeter fire, and it can be jettisoned if necessary. The launcher carries 10 7.2-inch rockets, which can be demolition, incendiary, or smoke. But the main use is demolition. Now, let's start from scratch. The T-73 kit comes in two crates. The launcher's in one, and in the second, the support assembly, two brackets, and interior controls. The brackets must be mounted first. To get them in exactly the right place, so that the gun sight can be used to aim the launcher, the tank maintenance crew marks off certain reference points. First, with the tank level, a plumb bob is dropped into the turret. The plumb line is parallel to the tank's vertical axis. Then, with the line as a reference, the position of the vertical axis is marked on the outside, in this case, about a foot from the line. Next, the plumb line is spotted so that it splits the gun barrel in half. The line is carried back and over the turret. A mark is made which determines the center of the turret. The brackets will be mounted an equal distance on either side of this center. Now, as a temporary measure, a wooden jig is placed on the turret. It holds the support frame in the right position until the brackets for the frame are welded in place. Before the support frame is picked up by a tank retriever, the center section of its armor plate is removed so the frame will fit on the wooden jig. The position of the support frame is checked by measuring from its center to the vertical axis of the turret, which was the first reference point marked on the tank. To be sure the arms of the support frame are equidistant from the turret center, the men measure the distance between the horizontal center line of the turret and each arm of the support frame. They check to make sure that the frame is at right angles to the turret. Because no two turrets are identical, the brackets must be cut and fitted for each tank. To do this, cardboard templates are cut to match each side of the bracket. The cardboard templates are then put into position against the turret in the place where the actual brackets are to go. The templates are marked and then trimmed to fit the exact contour of the turret. Of course, this is done for the top and bottom templates of both brackets. To get an even more accurate fit, the outline of the trimmed template is transferred to sheet metal. Actually, either cardboard or metal can be used alone. But for the best fit, both steps are advisable. The metal template is checked for fit. The template outlines are then traced on the brackets, each template on the proper side. The brackets are cut to shape by acetylene torch. Now, to help keep the brackets in place until they're welded, wooden blocks are used as supports. With a carpenter's level and a tape, the men make sure the brackets are in the right position. tack welding is used in case further adjustment is needed. Brackets on both sides are welded the same way. Once the brackets are tack welded in place, the wooden jig is removed and the support frame lowered on the brackets. The jettisoning latches are secured. Here again, it is only fitted for size. When the crew is sure all parts fit perfectly, the support frame will be removed and the brackets welded permanently. While this work is being done, part of the crew installs controls inside the tank.